Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you and to adore you for your goodness and for your mercy that endure forever. As I share your word, use me as a vessel to be a blessing to your people. How I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart may be pleasing to thee and in line with your guidance, Lord. Spirit of the living God, take over. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus against any attacks that bring destruction and wastage of time, because I realize time is of essence. Take over, Lord. May this word go forth like good seed upon your hearts of your people as good ground to bear fruits that will encourage them and empower them and prepare them for your second coming in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Welcome to One Word TV. I'm your presenter, Pastor Florence Minor of the program Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. I'm broadcasting live all the way from Minnesota, USA, and this is a production of One Word Digital Media, which is situated in Seattle, Washington. God is good. The title of my message today will be Singing Joy to the Lord. Joy heals our soul and our physical bodies. Because when you are angry, it affects you. And in the same way, when you are happy, it affects you. Have you ever smiled to somebody who was mad and you see their face brightening, even though they might be tensed up a little bit? As you continue, same when you sing a song of joy. My words of reference will be from the book of Psalms 95, and it says, in actual fact, the subheading on my Bible says a call to worship and obedience. It says, oh, come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the Lord of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving. Let us shout joyfully to him with psalms. For the Lord is the great God and the great King above all gods. In his hands are the deep places of the earth. The heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Oh, come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you will hear your voice, note there, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion, as in the day of trial in the wilderness. When your fathers tested me, they tried me, though they saw my work. For 40 years, I was grieved with that generation and said, it is a people who go astray in their hearts, and they do not know my ways. So I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter my rest. May God bless his word. This is a psalm that reminds us of the way the Israelites were 40 days and 40 nights in the wilderness. But God was calling them to worship. There may be a wilderness in your life, but you still need to put on that joy of the Lord in you. Remember, the joy of the Lord is your strength, not what you are going through. We could be going through great tribulation. You could be going through rack. You could be going through joblessness, through divorce, through shaky marriages, through shaky careers. But remember, God is still God. He is still seated in his throne of grace. He does not change because our circumstances changes. That's why we need to recognize him. It's like we have our leaders. We have our presidents. Even when things are shaken, he is still there. Our God is in control of each and everything. And I want to remind you about the man Job, who was a righteous man. All he went through, God was still aware. But there was something that God said. He told Satan, do not touch his heart. It is my prayer that your heart will not be touched. Any other thing may be shaken, but remember, our God is the firm foundation on whom we can stand when there are storms that are raging or in our lives. Are there storms of sickness? You go to the doctor, you get this report. Whose report will you believe? Remember, the doctors have to do their work. Remember, as a human being, you have to do what you have to do. But we are not God. Only God who has the final word for us. And that's why we need to worship him, irrespective of what is going on. After Job went through so many things, he said, the Lord gives and the Lord take away. Blessed is his holy name. That one took a spiritual revived man who was stable, because even his next of kin, his better half, told him, why don't you curse God? By the way, that was like an advice. Why don't you curse God and die? Why are you suffering all this? my brother and my sister. There are advices we can get when we are going through hard situation and we fail how to understand. Or we can buy in that advice, which will be contrary to the will of God. How I pray that we can be able to shout joyfully to the lock of our salvation. That we can come to his presence with thanksgiving. You ask me, thanksgiving and what I'm going through? You're not thanking God for what you're going through. You are thanking God for who is with you as you go through what you are going through. So may the Lord bless you to know that there is a joy in you that is planted at the core of your heart, in your spirit, by the Lord God. And he knows what is going on. Verse 6 is, oh come, let us worship and bow. Yeah, we bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our maker, as we cry and tell God, irrespective of what is going on, I want to thank you. And you'll be surprised that you'll burst up a peace in your heart and you'll be able to sleep well. You'll be able to be an encouragement to somebody else in the future. So may the Lord bless you. May this psalm be an encouragement to you. Yes. And I also want to read verse 7. For he is our God, and we are his people, of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Today, if you'll hear his voice, do not harden your heart. Are you hearing the voice of worshiping the Lord in the midst of your chaos? Do not harden your heart. Tell God. The good thing I like about God is, he's our Father. Tell him, God, I'm going through a situation. I should not be praising you. But because you are God, I'm just going to worship you. And you can say also like a psalmist who said, oh, bless the Lord, oh my soul. The psalmist was talking to his soul. I pray that God will help you and me to be able to tell our soul, praise the Lord, oh my soul. Irrespective of what is going on, irrespective of the report I've received, praise the Lord, oh my soul. Let us pray. Father God, help us to know that you are in control of each and everything, despite what we go through, despite what we hear, despite what we see. God Almighty, you still remain at your throne. Even when battles rage, when battles come, it is you who said that no weapon fashioned against us will prosper. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. You are there, you have never trusted the Lord. I want to encourage you, invite the Lord. When you have this personal relationship, you'll be able to understand what I'm talking about. Praising and worshiping God with joy in the midst of a situation that I had. You want to say this prayer after me? Lord Jesus, I come before you. I give my life to you. I repent of my sins. Write my name in the book of life and give me a desire to grow spiritually. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. If you have prayed that prayer, you've been transformed. The old is gone and the new has come. Next step, look for a church nearby where you live that you can call your home church, that you can be able to be blessed, where you can be equipped, where you can be corrected and rebuked to be able to be a workman who need not be ashamed, and the Lord will bless you. You can continue to listen to this message and other messages by dialing 605-781-3266. You can also search 11 Miracle Radio that way using your smartphone. Download the app 11 Digital Media. You'll be blessed 24/7. When you are blessed, be a blessing to other people by sharing. I love you, and God loves you the most. This is your home for spiritual guidance, your voice of hope. And remember to subscribe to our channel, celebrate your moment with joy. Thank you.